Welcome to Mia Marvels, a show where we explore the most significant inventions and innovations in history. On tonight's episode, we're diving into the 2000s, a decade marked by the rapid growth of the digital world. Can you guess what the most important digital innovation of the 2000s was? Let's find out as we count down the top four. As we reveal each digital innovation, we'll see how they impacted daily life and pop culture, as well as some concerns they raised. Mia Marvel's The 2000s episode starts now. We're starting our countdown with the fourth most important digital innovation of the 2000s, the iPod. Developed by Apple in 2001, the iPod revolutionized the music industry by allowing users to store thousands of songs on this small, portable device. People no longer had to purchase a bunch of CDs and carry bulky CD players on the go. They could purchase and download music straight to their iPod, putting an entire digital music library in their hands. Digital downloads also made music more affordable. Users could purchase individual songs instead of entire albums, reducing the cost of enjoying a variety of music. This changed the way the music industry functioned. Artists could now release music on their own without having to rely on big production companies for song releases. Quickly, the iPod became a status symbol. The iconic Apple logo became an accessory synonymous with popularity. And despite its individual use, the iPod also influenced the social experience of music. Sharing digital playlists and headphones became a way for people to experience and bond over music together. However, as the iPod increased in popularity, it raised some concerns. First, many brick-and-mortar music stores began to struggle. Consumers preferred the convenience and selection of digital music, leading to the downfall of physical media, such as CDs. Also, piracy, the illegal copying, downloading, or sharing of copyrighted materials, became a major concern. Many people found ways to illegally download music through file-sharing networks like this one, causing significant losses to the music industry. This led to regulations, like the Digital Millennium Copyright Act, which protects the rights of creators by making it illegal to copy or share their work without permission. So, how does the way you enjoy music today compare to how people enjoyed music in the early 2000s? Coming in at number three, let me introduce the next most important digital innovation of the 2000s, video streaming sites. How do you think streaming sites like YouTube changed entertainment and how people accessed information? These platforms offered instant access to a diverse range of content, providing a whole new world of entertainment, especially for teenagers. YouTube became a place to learn new things, from makeup tutorials to history lessons, making education more accessible and entertaining. It also led to the rise of vlogging culture, as people began to document their daily lives and routines for the world to see. Suddenly, YouTubers became celebrities, amassing fans and influencing trends as much as Hollywood stars. With the ability to share videos, they could go viral, making cultural phenomena and connecting people worldwide. Sites like YouTube also amplified diverse voices and perspectives, providing a platform for underrepresented communities, and playing a significant role in political and social movements. YouTube became a place to discuss politics, influence elections, and inspire social activism. However, the rise of video streaming sites raised concerns. Think about concerns raised as the iPod grew in popularity. Can you think of any similar issues that might arise with video streaming sites? First, similar to the piracy concerns with music, the ease of uploading and sharing video content often led to copyright infringement. Users sometimes shared content without the permission of the original creator. Additionally, concerns about screen time sparked debates about the impact of constant media consumption on mental health, especially for young audiences. So, what role do video streaming websites or apps play in your life? What strategies do you use to manage your screen time? All right, we're ready to introduce the runner-up in this Mia Marvels Countdown, a digital tool that has completely transformed the way we communicate. Can you guess what it is? Social media, of course. The social media revolution began in the early 2000s with sites like MySpace, where users could create their custom profile, a new form of self-expression. From there, they could share everything from photos to their favorite songs. MySpace laid the groundwork for other social media sites like Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram, which launched throughout the 2000s. Why do you think we've ranked social media as one of the most significant innovations? In the digital era, social media has redefined the way we connect with the world around us. With these tools, people share their thoughts, memories, and experiences instantly, creating digital scrapbooks for their real-world lives. Viral memes and hashtags became the new language of this digital world, and a way to comment on cultural, social, and political issues. Users who amassed a large amount of likes and followers became social media stars, planting the seeds of influencer culture. But it wasn't just about connecting with friends. As social media evolved, professional networking sites like LinkedIn were developed, connecting job seekers and employers in an online professional world. Social media also revolutionized politics, allowing for immediate and widespread sharing of political content, mobilization of groups, and direct communication with politicians or activists. But as social media became an integral part of society, it also raised some concerns. Think about how quickly information spreads on social media and how anyone can post anything. What issues might arise from the rapid spread of information? Well, one major issue was the spread of misinformation, especially as social media became a platform for politics. Users often share misleading articles or information that hasn't been fact-checked, sometimes even without realizing it's false. The nature of social media algorithms, which automatically sort, prioritize, and deliver content to users based on their preferences and interactions, can lead to promotion of more sensational, controversial, or biased content. These algorithms also create echo chambers, or situations in which people are exposed only to opinions and information that reinforce their existing beliefs. Both misinformation and echo chambers have a huge impact on politics, as people aren't always exposed to both sides of the story on social media, regardless of the infinite content. So think about these issues. What strategies do you use to fact-check information that you see online? We've reached the end of our countdown. Have you guessed what the number one most significant digital innovation of the 2000s was? This tool put all the previous innovations that we mentioned into the palm of our hands. Taking first place in Mia Marvel's 2000s countdown, the smartphone. Unlike cell phones before them, smartphones are mini computers, bringing the power of the internet anywhere you go. Although there were some earlier versions of smartphones, in 2002, the BlackBerry was released, one of the first phones to feature a full keyboard and combine the power of the internet with mobile communication. The BlackBerry and other early smartphones were typically used in the business world. That was until 2007, when Apple released a new kind of smartphone that would completely dominate the industry, the iPhone. Can you think of a few ways the iPhone changed society? The first iPhone included simple apps to make life easier. But soon, Apple released new versions that featured the App Store. Users can now bring Facebook, YouTube, and even virtual games anywhere they went. It also included iTunes, meaning users could ditch their iPods and purchase and download music straight to their phones. The camera feature led to the rise of selfie culture, a cultural phenomenon that became another new mode of self-expression. But as more and more Americans became smartphone users, some concerns were raised. First, smartphones store a lot of personal information like contacts, messages, search histories, and location data. This raised concerns about privacy and security, as many people began to question how their personal information could be used, stored, and shared. And while smartphones are all about connection, they can also be isolating. The ease of instant communication led to worries that real face-to-face interactions would be reduced as people spent more and more time on screens. So what strategies can you use to balance the benefits of smartphone use with the potential drawbacks? That's it for this episode of Mia Marvels. We've explored the top four digital innovations of the 2000s. Now that you know the significance of these tools, you'll investigate how they influenced social, political, and economic issues and events throughout the decade in your PDF. Until next time, think about the impact these tools still have on daily life today, and how you can use them to make history. Hey, hey.